in session this morning. Okay. Anybody sore a little bit? Just being honest. A little bit sore, a little bit tired, huh? A lot of rest. Okay. A lot of rest. Okay. I want to talk to you this morning a little bit about, before you get going, okay? I was thinking about this last night, okay? There's a couple things that hold people back, in my opinion, okay? And they kind of work together, okay? But number one, okay, commitment. Okay, commitment or lack of, not enough, okay? Another one is expectations. But, you know, to me, they're intertwined, okay? Sometimes for some people, one comes a little bit ahead of the other one. Sometimes it's the, you know, it's like the chicken or the egg thing, okay? So your commitment. If we all gave you a recipe and said, hey, if you do this, this, and this, like the lifting is 3 days a week or whatever it is, the running, you know, you got to get your wrestling. You do these things, A, B, and C, you will win this, whatever it is. What do you want to win? Nationals. You want to win nationals. Okay, if you do A, B, and C, you will win nationals. Does it work like that? It doesn't really work like that. So some people hold off on the commitment part, because there's no guaranteed recipe for automatic success, okay? So they're a little bit afraid to jump in with both feet, or a little hesitant. I don't know if afraid is the right word, a little hesitant. The payoff might not be there, okay? The payoff might not be there. You know when you go to a job where someone's your boss, that if you work from 9 to 5, this is what you get an hour a lot of times, you're gonna get paid X amount. Some people, like, they don't go and start their own business or do their own thing because it's a little bit of risk. There's no guarantee. Usually this guy, like, who's running it, is the last guy, you know, to get paid if they're doing it right, the honest person, everybody else. So they hold back a little bit on they do that. There's no guarantees, okay? It's out of their comfort zone a little bit, you know? And that's fine. There's just, everybody can do whatever they want, right? So, but then your expectations sometimes will hold you back a little bit in a few ways, right? If you don't expect to win or to have success, you know, when you step out on that mat or in that arena or whatever it is, that's going to impact you a little bit, okay? So the more you can visualize and see yourself as a winner in whatever it is a good thing, okay? We really want to have that. We want to have that positive mindset. But for some, it doesn't come automatic, okay? For some, it doesn't come automatic. Everybody has, like, you know, little walls or barriers, you know, and we got to continue to push those back a little bit. We got to continue to push them back. And it really comes through preparation for most people, most of us, okay? Which, again, preparation is related to commitment, okay? If we fully on commit to something, not knowing for sure what the payoff is going to be, if we're going to stand on which step we're going to stand on, and heck, if we're not going to at all, if we're going to come up short, if we're going to make it, but if we fully commit, okay, that will drive our expectations. The more you prepare, right? Most of you could agree, right? The more you prepare, you really feel prepared for something, if it's a presentation, if it's a speech, if it's your history test, okay? If it's a wrestling match, whatever it is, the more you prepare, you feel more confident going in, yeah? Correct? Yeah. When you don't prepare, you kind of go in there and aren't real confident, right? Has anybody been there? Be honest. You might not be into taking tests yet, but I had to take a lot of them. I don't know if you, huh? Yeah? You got anxiety, right? Because you don't do the preparation, and then you're a little bit nervous. You got all that going for you, which inhibits your performance like even a little bit more. Okay. So all this stuff is like, and sometimes you're mentally and physically worn out before you even go out on the mat, and you can't represent yourself the best. Okay? So I want to talk a little bit about that before we get going. Okay? You have to commit, whatever it is. And some of you might have different commitment levels. I understand that. But you, it's up to you. We talked about this the other day. It's up to you. You have the powerful, powerful, okay, choice of it being up to you. You get to decide what you want to be. You get to decide what you want to do, what you want to accomplish. And then you can make a plan. And then you got to execute the plan. Okay? So decide what you want. Okay? Make up your mind. What do you want out of this? What do you want out of this? What do you want out of school? What do you want to accomplish? What, you know, what's your goals? Make a plan. If you don't know how, and let's be honest, like when I was like, I didn't know what to do at your guys' age. So you have these resources. Okay? And maybe some of all of us don't have the perfect answer, but we all have experience. Find these guys, ask them, ask your coaches, ask your parents, what should I do? You know, what should I do? This is what I want to do. What do you think I need to do? Ask other people that have done it, you know? And then come up with a plan, work on it, okay? Work on executing the plan, okay? Don't just have the plan, but work diligently to do it, okay? I don't want to get too far off, but I used to keep a log, right? I used to keep a log, my training log, and it worked for a couple reasons. Number one, at the end of the week, I could look at it, and I could really feel good, okay, most of the time, about what I'd done that week. And then before I went into competitions, I'd look and like, okay, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, that was there. I did this Thursday, I did it. And it's a self-fulfilling prophecy, right? You look and you're like, God dang, I expect to win. I am ready. I am ready to compete. I'm ready to perform well. I'm ready to do my best, have my best performance because I've done the work. And all the little things like, right? I don't think my opponent has done this, right? I don't think he's done this. He wasn't up at 6 in the morning running. He wasn't coming in for 45 minutes of hard drill after that, working at afternoon practice. He didn't do the little things, you know? He didn't do the little things I did. He can't wrestle as hard as I can, right? He cannot wrestle as hard. There's no way, okay? Or the times I didn't do what I should have, I could look back and be like, you know, I missed a workout this week. So it's an accountability thing too, right? Again, you can fool the other people around, but on Sunday when I got to look at my thing, the last week, okay, what my week looked like if I had the workouts in and I didn't have them in, I could look. Okay, well, that can't happen again. Okay, and you can always find an excuse, a million, okay, reasons like why you can't do something. Why you don't have enough time, why you don't have a wrestling partner, the coach won't open the room, this, that, the other. You got to find one reason you can get better. One, that's it. There's going to be, and everyone will give them to you too. Huh? You can give them to yourself, but most people will back, yeah, you know. Yeah, you're not from a wrestling school. You're wrestling. What does that mean? Huh? What does that mean? Okay, we did drills yesterday. Coach Vid did drills yesterday. Those attack hand drills. Could you do those anywhere? With or without a partner? Could you do those repetition? Boom, boom, boom. Could you do that spin drill we did yesterday? Could you do stance and motion? Like, you don't need it. Anybody. Okay, so there's always a million and one excuses why you can't do something. Okay. Why you can't better yourself, why you can't. I'll tell you what, there's a mountain right over there. If I don't have a workout partner, they all go on vacation for the summer. I can be running. I seen a lot of guys that got really strong, didn't have a weight set in the world, did exercises, push-ups, crunches, okay, jump squats. Anything. I mean, they didn't have weights back centuries ago, but man, if you guys are into history, I like watching a lot of those old shows. You see some of those guys? You see some of those guys? You ever see 300?
Yeah.
I don't think they had any barbell sets back then. Okay. There were no Airdynes. There weren't even Thighmasters. You guys remember Pepe? You used to have a Thigh Master, right? You remember the Thigh Master, Suzanne Summers, Thigh Master? Used to love that commercial. Okay? About 14, 15. Great stuff. Okay? Always can get better. Always. Ready to warm up? Legend, can you get warmed up? Hit it!